Pipe doesn't work.
I'm back, fuckers. I made
Yay.
It.
Oh shit, I had the hookers.
Oh, but I'm okay with hookers. That's fine. That works okay. Oh shit. Fucking. I don't know what happened. Router suddenly wigged out and lost connection to the internet.
Router?
Yes.
Like a roto-router?
I don't know why you were going to use roto-router as an example, but I just knew you would.
Because it's the only other router. It's a router.
The router.
It's a router.
The router.
We just call it a router. I was about to say, we just call it a
the router!
It's like you've been routed?
Oi.
Retreat! Retreat!
Anyway. Fuck, where were we? Right, anyway, yes, there's an owl on Zaire's arm, and it's perching and looking between the two of you curiously.
I asked Rose to see it with her special eyes.
I look at it.
I'm honestly curious to see what happens.
What happens when you look at like typically otherworldly things with your special eyes, Rose? Like, is there any way to pick up that they're a little bit awkward, or is it just only ghosts?
I can only see ghosts with the eye. Like, I can't see spirits or anything.
Yeah. Okay, let's have a look here.
Now, out of character knowledge, I don't know if Strix count as ghosts.
I was gonna say, like, I don't think the capital O owls qualify then.
Isn't it left deliberately vague? At least that's what I read.
It is. It is left deliberately vague.
So it's up to you.
Okay. There is something to this owl, Rose. Like, you're looking quite definitely at an owl. It's physical and it is alive, and your eyes see this normally. However, it's like it's got an after image that is perched on its shoulders. Like, if you were to, like, there's something stood behind it, but you can't see behind it. Like, tilting your head from side to side makes your perception of it shift side to side as well. Like, opposite angles. It's like it's something that's just a little bit too far. Like, if you stood up a little bit higher to try and peek over it, like, the after image behind it seems to sink down a smidgen.
Ha. Huh.
There's definitely something there, but trying to observe it doesn't really work.
Where the hell did you get this thing?
I have. I bought it.
Where?
At a place. You can't see Sire's eyes shifting because of sunglasses, but you have a feeling that his eyes are shifting.
The owl will sort of peck it at the inside of its wings, preening.
Okay.
Would you like to pet the owl?
Not really.
Zaire will pet the owl instead.
And it then hoots. He will give... Hoot!
Huh.
And then Zaire will give it a juicy rat before letting Madame Hoots get back on her way.
Oh yeah, it fucking demolishes that rat. Like, it goes down with crunching noises in its throat.
Aw, so adorable.
Why'd you just have a rat in your pocket?
Because I own an owl.
It's a good argument.
With a little push, he kind of lets Madame Hoots fly off away.
Yep.
To go about their business.
Flutter, flutter, flap, flap.
I just wanted to make sure that there was nothing odd about her.
There's definitely something odd about her.
Odd how? What did you see?
It's like a ghostly afterimage of it.
Is she a spirit?
No, I can't see spirits.
So, she's a sort of ghost?
Some kind of ghost.
Zaire will
maybe
kind of look...
possessed? I don't know. I've never seen anything like that before.
Well, it was just a matter that I wanted your expertise on. I thought that maybe you would know something of her true nature.
You've seen possessed people before, by the way. They just... It's not like the ghost is physically in possessed people. Like, imagine that it looks like a parent is always holding hands with their child. It's just the ghost is there and in contact.
It looks like a stand.
Huh.
Anyway, so...
I don't know what to tell you. That thing's weird.
Well, either way, since that was all I wanted of you, I guess we can go about the business going down to the Hail Mary, yes?
Yeah. I want to talk to, like, Claire about that. I don't know, she's the bookie type.
Well, actually, there's a reason I haven't seen everybody.
Yeah?
Yes, I want to make sure I have certain things in order before I go back and see everyone. The reason why I'm meeting with you is because I know you can keep a secret and are often split up.
Are often what? You cut off.
And that you're often split apart from the group. I also thought you might know something of Madame Hoots' nature, so I figured that it was worth meeting you.
I see. So you bought this owl and you didn't even know what it was.
It talked.
It can talk.
Yes.
Okay.
I mean, how could I not get a
talking animal? I was about to say talking animals, you know, don't exist. But I'm just going to take your word for it this time.
We live in a magical time where many things are possible.
Many fucked up weird things.
Yeah, your master didn't really teach you much vampire-y stuff, did he, Rose?
No.
No.
He
plucked out the eye and fucked off.
Yeah. He plucked out the eye, taught me about the fucking ghosts and about Ged's time off every year or so.
Yep.
And fucked right the fuck off and what's it? Rose doesn't spend much time at Elysium.
Yeah, okay. There is no way that pretty you would know this information.
Solo.
Will be trained in the shooty shooty bang bangs.
Yep. I mean, you've got wits out the arse, so if you want to roll like something and fish for five, then I might give you something.
Fish fried.
Cool. That's exactly what I was hoping to hear. So there you go. Do you explain any more about the Zaya missing fiasco?
I mean, Rose didn't ask, and I don't fully know.
Okay.
To be fair, like, Rose didn't even know you're missing.
Yes, this is her first time trying to contact Zaya, and she succeeded.
Zaya doesn't know that. And since Rose is not acting like anything strange, Zaya is still kind of reluctant to bring it up, as long as he doesn't know exactly what happened. I mean, after the job, maybe we can talk about it.
Yep.
Right now, Rose has a place to be, and Zaya has a job.
Yeah. We don't want to be late.
So Zaya is going to poop down to the Hail Mary.
Yep. And again, as usual, like, your owl follows along, but at an exceptional distance, but it is present. You can feel it like that tugging.
Fuck. Out of character. Oh, fuck.
Zaire poots along and comes to whatever just happened.
Yay. Okay. You've introduced Rose to the owl. Oh, that's so delightful. Okay.
Are there any popular songs about talking owls?
Popular songs about talking owls?
Specifically, because Zaya will be playing said songs.
Hoot Riot?
Will Zaya be listening to Owl City?
When can I see you again? I'm gonna see you again.
No, we drive down to the Hail Mary. Zaire will try to dress, I guess, like a bodyguard right now, since he didn't come prepared.
Yep. I mean, it's not the first time that Zaire's been in this area. Like, this is one of your typical hunting grounds for beating the shit out of muggers and stuff and drinking them dry, because it's fun to play Batman the Vampire.
It is. Damn it, DCL. Why would you beat the shit out of muggles?
He has a magic... He doesn't care about the fucking muggles. He's got a magic owl now, bitch. It's Hogwarts. Oh, Hogwarts I'm up in this Hogwarts. Bee.
I ain't one of them anymore.
Stupid muggles.
Yeah, now cast a spell, bitch.
Dead werewolf of Aramis.
Alright. Well, yep. We drive down to the Hail Mary.
Yep, when you get there, it's, you can hear, like, pounding bass tunes before you've even really, before, like, the Hail Mary itself comes into view.
Before we get out of the car, there we'll kind of turn over to Rose and ask, like, is this an M19 moment or an assault rifle moment?
This is a, you stay in the car unless shit hits the fan moment.
All right, then.
Would both of you like to give me wits composure, please? Rose, you're a trained observer, so you get whatever that bonus was again.
It's today, okay. Wits composure, you say?
I believe so. It's the standard for perceptions.
First roll of the day is pretty good.
Strong.
Stronger than mine.
Even with your 9 again and the identical number of dice, just fucking crushed. Alright. So, Zaire, when you're looking around out there, it's... You've been in this area before. It's definitely as occupied as you're used to seeing it. Like, there are crowds of people, like, they fucking pile into this abandoned church and get shit hammered with the goth girls, and then they sort of disappearify. Oh god, I'm the worst at forgetting. You're right. I forgot to ask about everyone's aspirations and shit this session, so we should probably hit those before we continue on and get carried away, because I need to know what everyone has as their aspirations for the session. There are some people with a couple of empty spots.
Get rid of this damn artifact.
Smart. Get rid of the damn artifact. You have space for a third one as well. DCL, you have space for two aspirations.
Oh wait, shit, did I ever add the experience for, like, leading the party to glory, or did I never get that?
You did, it was worth 3 total beats in the end.
I'm just gonna, I have 3 experience in 3 beats, so I'm just gonna say I probably did.
You probably did, yes. And Stray, you have space for an aspiration as well.
Oh, do I?
Yep.
Did I already do the thing, because I still have further my coil 3 beats, because I got like a monumental 11 successes at the end, but you just said that counted as more beats toward my thing.
Yeah, it's scored in. You advanced research on your coil, and to gain like more progress in your coil, like it's not going to be a research case, it's going to be a finding, like it's going to involve finding a kindred, or it's going to involve finding someone. You can't really research a point when you've been essentially handed a dead end when as far as your research has taken you. So I let you cash in advancing your research so that you could move on to a new aspiration.
Oh, so I got those 3 beats. I just
you gained
had it
2
still
beats.
Under aspiration. 2 beats. Why
you
gained did
2 beats.
Say 3. Okay. All right, then let me delete that off my thing and then add 2 more beats.
All right. So is spoiling Madame Hoots an aspiration?
It's a very pointless aspiration because it's fucking there's nothing important about it. You can take it, but I'm not even awarding you a beat for it. I'll give you a half beat.
All right. Well, on the serious note, I guess the obvious aspiration is what the hell happened in that month. And
Yep.
Would that finding out what happened include the history of Madame Hoots? Because I still want to figure out exactly what's going on with Madame Hoots.
Understand Madame Hoots, I suppose, would be a reasonable one. Because yes, that is a different story to finding out what happened in the month. I can tell you that much. It's related, but it won't give you every piece of that puzzle. But finding out what Madame Hoots is technically a simple matter. Although how simple you make it will up the danger quotient. Let's put it this way: you were told explicitly, "Don't tell anyone." Thankfully, the one person you went to doesn't fucking know anything about them. Thankfully, otherwise you'd actually might be in a bit of trouble.
Okay.
So yes.
I'm glad you didn't call me.
Oh yeah. You would be, it'd be in danger. You were warned of this. I have
like 3 dots in a cult.
Yes, Claire would be able to figure this one out pretty adeptly. And even if she didn't figure it out, I imagine that would make you want to figure it out more.
Yeah.
And the moment you went to an elder and was like, "My friend has a talking owl," they'd probably go send the fucking the fucking monster killers out.
Yeah, that's when the axes would come out. Yep. And let's just not get involved in that. Yeah. Can I have a few minutes to think about an aspiration?
Of course. You can have as long as you need, as long as it's until the end of the session. And Lily, you have space for a third aspiration. You've got figure out why the hunters hate you has got a plus in it. You've got get rid of the damned artifact and space for another.
I mean, shit. So just making sure. Madame Hoots specifically said don't tell her anybody about her?
Correct. She said that you probably don't want to go to people about her. It would be dangerous for the both of you.
Alright.
And the first thing you did was like, "Hey, look at my magic talking owl!"
Yeah. That's fair. I realized after DCO did that, it's like, I'm pretty sure he's forgotten that he was told specifically by Madame Hoots, "Don't tell anyone, it would be dangerous for us both, Master."
I mean, it's a talking owl. I did not want to show that.
You
off.
Had to tell at least one person, I know. It's like when you have that amazing secret.
Gotta tell at least somebody.
Yeah. Somebody, somebody, somebody.
Two can keep a secret if one of them is dead.
Well, when Rose was like, "Oh yeah, we should ask Claire," I was like, "Well, I guess I should start rolling stats for Herrera now."
Yeah.
Well, now that I remember not to ask, I'll try a different route of unsolving the mystery of Madame Hoots.
Yep. Or you can just try it in a roundabout fashion that doesn't involve you saying, "I've got a talking owl."
It's so tempting, though.
I mean, you're welcome to do it that way.
Well, Rose did refer Sayer to Claire.
Yeah, but the only reason why I agreed to meet up with Rose is kind of a loner from the group and keeps secrets. So I trust Rose.
It's true. Rose is unaffiliated with any group. Technically, just like you are, Zaire.
Yeah, that's the main reason why I met up with Rose. And I was like, if anybody I know would know about this and could possibly not bring back Blowback with the group, it would probably be Rose.
That's true. She is a good one to go to. And she did see something. You know that there is something super... Well, you know that now, for sure, there's something supernatural about your talking owl.
Just to make sure, I can't spend my beats once I have them, right? I don't have to wait till like the end of session, stuff like that.
You can, if you have beats and you want to put them into experience, like beats turn into experience and experience is spent on stuff. Yes, you're welcome to do that.
All right, thanks.
That's important to remember.
It's what, 3 beats for an experience or 4? I don't know.
5.
Five.
Wow. Okay, never mind then.
Yeah. On the character sheet, you'll see.
Yeah, there should be a little
spot ticker. For 5 beats.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
It's okay. Right.
I did actually want to say it before. Should be using conditions more.
Conditions?
Because conditions, a lot of conditions will offer beats for overcoming them.
That's true. That's something I need to inflict you guys with more often.
Yeah.
No, so I still myself need to learn running this game properly. You're right, conditions are something that I've neglected and should involve a lot more.
That's why I really don't like the beat system, because it ties in itself way too many other things.
Yeah, to like acquire, there are more ways to acquire beats than just like completing a mission and doing your aspirations. You can get beats for, you know, as you see before, like accepting, like taking a dramatic failure in place of a normal one. It also, if a failure would result in you taking a negative condition, and then overcoming that condition is usually what gets you the beat. And that's something I need to enforce on you guys more often. Put my vampire book in there. Okay.
Hey, Scow.
Yes?
I want to modify one aspiration, the sister one. I'm just going to change that to reunite with, rather than watch over. Right, so gonna do that.
Sure.
Still between like two for my third one, so I'll let you know later.
Okay, not a problem. Alright. Yes,
My third aspiration.
Yes.
Would be to teach what's your butt? Etienne to mind control people.
To mind control people? Oh, you want to teach her domination. Yes. Teach Etienne domination. Excellent. Excellent. I approve of teach Etienne domination. I mean, surely, yeah, I mean, it's a good thing she's a switch, huh?
She ain't using it on me. We're gonna find nice sluts. And I will feed on their blood and then feed it to her.
Oh. Such kinky.
Fucked
up, but also it's, you know, it's kind of, it's the weirdest concept of vampire romance I've ever heard. Like, I'll teach her my awesome tricks, and then we can get blood together and share it. It would be so cute.
Still a better love story than Twilight.
Oh, of course, absolutely. I mean, it involves actual conflict and interesting characters.
Almost anything's a better love story than Twilight.
That's true.
You know what isn't a better love story than Twilight?
50 Shits of Grey?
Yes.
There you go. Alright, so... Right, you're outside the Hail Mary, and you did a little looky-looky-loo. Zaya, you spend more time in this area. You recognize the typical busy crowd of people shambling back and forth. There is something about them that's a little bit off. That might take a slightly different kind of check. There is a van parked alongside the church that you see sometimes and you're pretty convinced belongs to drug pushers. As before, it's loud out here. There is pounding bass inside, and you know that this place can get pretty fucking dodgy, but you do know that some kindred spend their time around here. Like, you've been in the area, you've possibly fed in the Hail Mary before. Like, it's not unusual grounds, and it's considered currently to be neutral, but you know that situation was changing last time you were there. Like, someone probably is starting to take over, like, this is their proprietary feeding grounds, but right now it's up for grabs.
Alright, so instincts are saying something's up, so what do I roll to try to investigate that a little bit more?
Let's go with Wits Empathy.
Alright.
Which you're incredible at.
That is what Zaire was geared for.
It is. He is incredibly good at understanding people. Which is the funnest because he's so fucking naive. Okay. People party hard around here, and you know that to be true. But there is a familiar glaze to some of them that you recognize as vampire feedings. But it's like a lot of people are that level of minced up, and that's unusual. That would be like if lots of kindred at once were doing a bunch of feeding, but, you know, probably isn't the case.
Zaire is going to take out a handgun and hand it to Rose.
Oh, you cut off there after saying hand it to Rose.
TCL?
Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, I was waiting for Rose to... Zaire will basically be, say, be careful. There's something odd going on. A tension in the air that I'm not used to feeling around here.
Alright. Yeah, I don't like the look of this place.
Yes, Rose, you are presumably less familiar with this area, but you tell me, I could be entirely wrong. Do you spend any time around here?
Probably not.
Okay. It's very, very ganglandy. I mean, you're at the very least, you have larceny connections, so you know that these areas are controlled by different gangs. Specifically, the Hail Mary is, like, in between a bunch of gangs at once. Like, it's on the outskirts of their influence, though, so it's unlikely you'd get any gang violence at the Hail Mary. It's why it's such a popular spot. There are a lot of fucked up people wandering around. No obvious dangers present themselves except for the usual of, you know, messing with people who are off their tits. Huh. Apparently I have quality options. That's fucking crazy. I made quality it, Twitch. I made it. I did it.
Made what?
On Twitch, I have quality options for my stream. I don't know how I became popular enough to get that, but hooray. Excellent. Holy shit.
You leveled up.
I did. I leveled up. I leveled up at Twitching. There you go.
Alright, so Zaire will ask, are you sure you want me staying in the car?
Take a look at all the, like, vamped up people. Alright, come on in.
Zaire will nod and get out the car.
Stay a few steps behind me, though.
Zaire will nod once more and keep his distance.
Alright. When you step out of the car, the both of you, like, you feel that Beast Hacklesley sensation. Like someone is brushing up at you, but no conflict initiates, I suppose. It's sort of the sensation that you're being felt out. A kindred or kindreds are aware of you now that you are here.
Alright.
But nobody has challenged you. I mean, this shouldn't be a surprise to Rose. You're here to meet one.
Right. Hate that sensation, though.
Yeah. It's like eyes watching you that you can't see.
Sometimes I feel like somebody's watching me, and I get no privacy.
I really had to resist saying Zaire Michael Jackson point.
Delightful.
Alright, let's do this.
Yep.
Next time, we're choosing like a fucking park.
Yep. Bass pounds and you can feel it deep down in your stomach. And people all over the place. And just now, the noise as well, now that you're outside of an armored car, is far more distinct. Like it was a muted sound while you were in there, because generally an armored car tends to be pretty well proofed against basic sound as well. There's a thump and a rattle. You can see that there are a few people who have given you the interesting look up and down because, you know, you are both attractive individuals. Zaire is drawing a lot of looks because he's dressed like a bodyguard. He's got that suited and booted look, whereas, I don't know, how's Rose dressed right now?
Typical leathers, dressed like, I don't know,
kind of
punky.
Yep. Punk, and I guess the typical dress code around the Hail Mary is goth slut. It's probably the easiest way to describe how everyone looks around here. It is a very VTM looking place. And yeah, a couple of blitz people will sort of approach you guys and be like, hey there, you come to party? Yeah, faded looks to them.
Zaire and puts on his best menacing scowl to try to discourage interaction with him.
Do you want to make a check to actually try and be intimidating?
Well, I need one.
There is an attribute role assigned to being intimidating, and it will judge your effectiveness or your control of the scene.
It is intimidating.
You intimidate with your presence, yes. Intimidation presence.
Unless you want to, like, level some subtle threats at them, that's manipulation.
Correct, yes. There are different ways to intimidate people.
Damn!
Nice.
Fuck.
Look at that.
Alright. You give these guys...
You got that intimidating black man look.
Yeah. Like, I mean, the cultures in this area are very, very mixed. Like, you're very close to the heavy black community, so there are quite a few people of any fucking ethnicity.
I've heard rumors of some badass going around beating up people.
Yeah, it's entirely possible, actually, that one of the people who is... one of the people you glare off is a face that you've broken before. One of the ones that you mashed up enough that you didn't drink from him, you quite happily drank from his companion, so he technically remembers you before you cleaned his fucking clock.
See, Zaire, this is why superheroes wear masks.
I mean, I'm just trying to make sure they give me a wide...
Yeah, you get a very wide berth, and like he'll like mutter off some warnings to some other girls, be like, you don't want to mess with that guy, that guy is fucking hench. And they'll leave you in peace. I realize that hench is a more Britishized term than American, actually.
Thank you. I was wondering, is this like...
Oh, yeah, that guy's hench, yo.
I was wondering if I'm like...
Getty herself is Amazonian, she's hench. It is also mildly more northern of an expression, but regardless.
Zaire will still keep his distance, but enjoy the space.
Yep.
He will make it known that he is on business and does not want to be disturbed. Through his silence.
Yeah, no, you maybe like a little tilt down of them sunshades, like people fucking back off. And you are left unaccosted walking up to the door. Indeed, there was going to be someone who stops you at the door, but he is like pulled away and being like told like, fucking don't mess with that guy, he's fucking serious business. And
he's hench, yeah.
He's hench as shit. Yeah, no, that guy is swole as fuck. He's fucking crazy, man. He will jack you right the hell out. Just out of his way. And yeah, the guy at the door won't stop either of you from walking in.
He'll jack you right the hell off.
I don't know about that.
Rip your dick clean off.
Oh, God.
Yeah. And if you thought it was loud outside, it is fucking incredibly loud inside now. Like, If the benches weren't bolted into the floor, they'd be rattling. And there are people dancing on tables. There are a couple of women in the cages. The classic, like, way fucked up nightclub. And there are a few people, like, they're dressed as, like, angels and devil strippers walking across poles. There is a few dudes, like, lined up against the wall. And there are a lot of people who have a very familiar faded look to their eyes that are just blitzed off of their fucking crowns. And indeed you can spot now the sources of a couple of those hackles, a number of kindred surrounded by similarly blitzed out men and women. It's unlikely that you guys would recognize them, but let's have a look here. Actually, Rose, can you give me a resolve presence check?
Oh, fuck.
You're actually pretty decent at that. Or possibly workable at presence resolve.
Any bonuses?
Nope. Okay. Okay. There is it's a sensation deep in your stomach, like you're really, really hungry, but you're pretty well fed. Usually you don't feel this hungry until, like, you're scraping the bottom of the barrel as far as Vitae is concerned. These people just look delicious to you for some fucking reason. Zaire, you don't appear to have this kind of problem walking around. Indeed, some people are still giving you a wide berth. You notice that maybe Rose is a smidgen hot under the collar right now. Yeah, these guys look absolutely delicious to you, Rose.
Fuck that. Too grungy.
Yeah. You don't like them when they're all drugged out?
Ah, no.
Yeah, you've got good feedings anyway.
Not when I'm on a job.
Yep.
Rose ain't about that.
Speaking of, Rose, you know about these types of kindred. They ain't the pretty kind.
Nazis.
Yes.
Nazis?
A Nosferatu. Yeah, they ain't...
I know, and I heard Nazis, and I was like, what?
Oh, no.
Nazis. They aren't necessarily all ugly.
No, but they...
But they are just unsettling as fuck.
Yeah, yeah. It's... Okay, it's a particularly... I wouldn't say it's a pale individual so much as, like, their skin is pallid and slightly yellowed. Their fangs are overgrown to the point that, like, normal humans would be like, you fucking got some pointy-ass teeth right there, bitch. His eyes are... They aren't even white either, they're bloodshot, but as though if all the capillaries were rendered completely stone-cold black. And there are a number of piercings covering his ears, his nostrils, and underneath his lips. He's wearing a leather jacket with no shirt underneath, and you can see that despite, like, this pallid, unhealthy-looking skin, like, very, very muscular, sturdy individual. And there are a number of, like, tattoos going down along the waist and likely traveling to parts south, and surrounded by a number of drugged-up men and women. He will push them all aside upon noticing you, in fact, Rose, and will make a come-hither motion.
I will motion for Zaire to stay put.
Yep.
Zaire gives a silent nod.
Move forward.
Okay. Just getting closer to this guy, like, the smell of blood is far richer here. And you suspect that there is some weird Nosferatu shit going on that's just making everything seem more appealing about what you're looking at, despite the obvious intensity of his distasteful impression.
I believe you've got something that I'm here for. Well, I'm here for plenty of things, but more specifically this evening, to collect.
You're my contact?
That'd be right. With the circle's regards.
Alright, pull the sword.
Oh, it did. Jeez, shit. Keep it under your coat for a second.
It's in a, like a...
Oh,
it's
is
all
it?
Rolled up.
That's all rolled up in a bag. Okay, yeah, he'll stare at it.
Alright. Excellent. And say, who's your friend over there? I wasn't told we were expecting another neutral party.
Nobody of note, just someone to watch my back.
Watch your back here?
And he gives you a grin that's all teeth. Realize it's not just his incisors that are sharp, the rest of him as well. He has no molars. And they are all pointy teeth.
Well, okay then. I understand this isn't the nicest place to do a little bit of a drop-off, but some of our friends have had a few eyes on them, and they're being a little bit careful. You know, it's dangerous times. They say the prince is waking up. Best watch out, he hates independence.
And he will then reach down into his pants. Like, on the inside of a ripped hole, you can see that there's probably an inseam. He reaches into this inseam and pulls out a checkbook. Scribbles a number into it. Signs it too. Nothing unusual about the check from the looks of it. Tears it out of the book and holds it up to you. And he holds out a hand expecting you to place the package into it the moment that he lets go of the check.
Out of character. Paying for a thievery job with a check.
Yes, it is. This is very, very unusual.
God.
In 2016?
Yeah, I mean, really?
There were a lot of zeros on that check, though.
A check?
Correct.
What, you've never accepted a payment by check?
Not really. It's not really...
Oh, I wouldn't worry. Our bank accounts are shockingly clean, actually, you might say. You'll find no issues with this.
It's just the transactions. That's how it's typically, you know, attract attention.
I'm aware, yes. But you'll find that our company is used to sending out transactions. We do a lot of projects work, you see. You'll find that this won't flag anyone at all. In fact, it's our preferred method of moving money. That way, if someone should betray us, they aren't that hard for us to find.
That's the thing, I usually don't like leaving a paper trail.
Oh, this isn't really a paper trail so much as just a friendly
digital
little bookmark.
Paper trail.
Yeah, it's more of a bookmark, I'd like to say. Just specifically between you and me. Well, you and the circle, I suppose. There's nothing to be afraid of unless you've decided to completely fuck us on this, Miss Lawson.
I have no intention of doing so.
Then you'll find that there is no issue with this transaction. He gives you that big old toothy grin.
Alright.
Yep.
Take the check, hand over the sword.
Yep, he doesn't let go of it until it's been placed into his hand, but you know how it goes. He will then... he looks at one of the women who are paying a little bit too much attention. Just sort of... To her, it's probably a very casual motion. Like, he's just sort of rubbing his forehead, generally with a hand. You can feel, like, a ripple that's just, like, along the back of your teeth, Rose. Pretty sure that he just dominated her. And she just looks at him blankly and then looks away again as though disinterested and starts a conversation with someone else similarly stoned out of their gourd. And then he'll smile and take a quick peek under the package and slip it between his legs and just hold it there.
Thank you very much, Miss Lawson. Can I interest you in any of our fine entertainments? You'll find that they are quite free for you around here.
That's good. Nothing for me.
Very well, then. I understand if I leave a little bit of an unsettling impression, but I'm generally our specialist at moving things around. People don't tend to fuck with me. You see, very obviously, when it comes to doing a transaction, you don't want to send along a little person. I assume that's why you've got your friend over there behind you, after all.
Yeah, just an insurance policy.
Exactly. And I am a walking insurance policy, let's put it that way. Still, if you hang around for another half an hour, there is a generally more approachable individual. They will... get my recommendation on seeing you, and if you have an interest in talking to them, I would very much recommend it.
I don't see why our business has been concluded.
Of course, but it's networking. Let's put it that way. She'd be very insulted if you didn't hang around for just a little bit.
I guess I can hear them out.
Ooh, shit. The Rozzers are here.
Oh, no.
Run. Look out for wee-woos.
Okay, they didn't catch me.
It's okay. Everything is safe.
Is it secret? Is it safe?
It's a secret. It's a secret.
Yep, there was a modicum of tension when it looked like you wouldn't hang around, but when you say that you do, he sort of relaxes again and leans back into his gang of girls. He'll look around for a moment and then hold a finger to his teeth and make a whistle. It's a very, very shrill sound coming from his mouth. But a... not a ragged-looking man, but a worn-out... individual. He's dressed nicely, but he looks very, very tired. We'll walk over and go,
hello there, can I assist you with anything? We happen to have plenty of drinks, plenty of girls, plenty of drugs. Any of that suit your fancy?
Inside of that, or we can get you a private room, perhaps. We have a couple of booths at the back.
A booth would be good.
Excellent. Please do follow me.
Motion for Zaire to follow.
Yep, he will guide you around. The dance floor itself is pretty busy, but skirting around the edge of it isn't too much of an issue. With this guy here, like, a couple of people pay you a lot of attention, but they notice that you've got an escort, let's say, who's still giving off the don't fuck with us vibe, and they leave you well enough alone. And yeah, there are,
just for dick measuring, is there don't fuck with us vibe as good as my don't fuck with me vibe?
No, I'm talking about you in particular. They aren't bothering either of you two because you, Zaire, are giving off the don't fuck with me vibe for this scene.
Okay, I heard that wrong then.
It's okay. Yeah, he takes you to, it looks like a typical, actually no, I suppose it wouldn't look like anything typical. It's actually a confession booth that someone has ripped the central panel out of so that it's just larger.
Every goddamn club here is a church.
The Hail Mary was specifically the church club. The other ones aren't.
I was pretty sure, like, the other one at the,
Lit Inferno?
No, what was the Hail Mary? The one where we were at for Mercer's thing?
No, you were at the Druk Society, which was just a strange gentleman's club.
I thought for certain you mentioned, like, confession booths.
Nope, I've never said that before.
In the YouTube comments down below, let me know. Were any other clubs...
Yeah, no, I've never mentioned confessional booth rooms. That's actually a first that I've ever said that.
Not for certain.
There's no way I drink that much. I try and stay a modicum of sober when I'm the actual GM. Drinking is for being a player. Indeed, I'm sober right now. I haven't had any alcohol yet. That's for later. That's
alcohol.
Alcohol. Saying words normally is boring.
Can I use that as an excuse next time?
For saying them, not for misspelling, sadly. If you're writing a thing at the very least. And anyway, yeah, he leads you to what looks like a confessional booth that's had its panels knocked out and has sort of spread it out. There are a bunch side by side, and when the door slides away, you can see that it's protected by a nice black curtain. It looks like you could fit four people in there relatively comfortably. There is a very small, like, central table just for putting drinks up on top of. It's I would say it's surprisingly clean. Like, the rest of the place smelt like sweat and blood and drugs and sex and all of that good stuff. In here, there's almost a hint of incensiness about the whole thing still.
Hmm.
And then he'll give you a smile and ask if there's anything either of you two would like he can have sent along to you, compliments of the house.
Nothing from me, thanks.
And he'll look towards Zaire. He does not seem bothered by you being intimidating. He's just being a host.
Zaire will shake his head.
Very well, then. Have yourselves a lovely wait. I believe that the owner will be along in 30 or so minutes. I believe that's what you're waiting for. He'll give you a smile, and you can detect the very, very hints of kindred teeth. And he will slip away.
Alright.
I don't like this.
Someone just said, what's that? The confession booth smells of incest.
Zaire will meditate very heavily on the logistics of owl care.
I don't like this. Keep your guard up, Zaire.
My guard is always up.
Yep. A half hour will pass. It's generally quite peaceful, and while that's happening, we all swoosh on over to Claire and Timothy.
Woo.
Meanwhile, in the Hall of Justice.
They're in a police station. It's more like in the front office of justice.
Oh my god.
Timothy, you're recognized by the receptionist up front when you arrive. And she will quickly direct you on to the boss. It is likely by this point... Let's see, she had to cross town to get to the Elysium and then on towards the police station. Probably about two, half two. As you're arriving, like, there is a... On one of the tables, usually you'd have, like, a couple of cops, like, in between shifts, sort of sat there drinking coffee or something. There is a photo frame just in the middle of one of the tables and a bunch of flowers. You would recognize them as funeral wreath flowers, that kind. The receptionist has sort of ragged, red-rimmed eyes, but she will muster up her best smile and go,
"Oh, hello there. I remember you from before. Is there something we can help you with?"
"Yes. I need to talk to the boss again."
"Of course, I'll just go get him. He's been very, very busy today, so I apologize if his temper's a little bit short." Not many of us have gotten much sleep, actually.
Oh, beepity booped. Oh no. Oh no. I'm not supposed to boop. I throw you away, phone.
Goodbye.
And yeah, she will direct you on. Do you knock at the door, or do you just wander on in?
I'll knock.
Yeah, you hear a very tired gruff. "Not now!" I'm gonna assume you try again. Or head in, regardless.
Yeah. Try again.
"I said not now. What is it?" And then there's some stomping and, like, you can hear a drawer being slammed before he'll open up the door. And then his face pales a bit on seeing you. "Oh, not again. Come in, come in." And he, like, wipes the corner of one of his nose and will sort of indicate a chair. When he sees you got a friend as well, he's like, "Oh, fuck, there's more of you too. All right, what is it? What do you need? Why have you come back to me?"
"We have a mutual problem."
"Do you? Do we have a mutual problem? Go ahead. Go ahead."
"The altercation that took place, I assume you know the one I am referring to."
"We have altercations all day and all night. But I'm assuming you're talking about the one where some freak killed two of our guys and survived a number of rounds to the back and presumably to the neck and continued running. Yes?"
"Yes."
"All right, then. Well, if you're intending to solve this problem, we would very much appreciate it, I suppose." When he says appreciate, like, there is a great measure of disgust, distaste, and discomfort about this man. When last time you saw him, he had that typical, like, completely wired because he was just probably taking all the medication to stay awake. There is no resolving how exhausted he looks right now. And you can detect, like, the hints of perhaps white powder at the corner of his nose. But he will, you know, adjust himself and sit up. Then, yeah, he just looks like the man who has not seen a day's sleep in two. It's been a week since you've seen him. You wouldn't be surprised if he hasn't slept since then. "All right, before you ask me anything, how much do you know? Hmm?"
"Tim, we'll look at Clem.
We know that there was a fight. We know that when shot, the assailant managed to get away without apparently slowing down at all. We came to ascertain if this was merely a human on drugs or a powerful member of our kind, perhaps. A ghoul."
"Well, I can safely say that it wasn't any kind of drugs. If there's a drug that gives you the strength to rip limbs from people and resist bullet shots, then honestly, I would love to get my hands on some of that." "No. Okay. So you're coming to us with less information than we have." "It's not PCP. He's on PCP, it is. No, I sincerely doubt it's drugs unless all of our boys miss, but I'm fairly convinced that they're not lying. They probably did shoot that man. And, well, last time someone got shot like that, it was Kindred. It was one of you folks. It was one of those boys of the night. And there was a cover-up involved, and very, very recently, a couple of your associates came to do a little covering up, and I had to lay off two of my particularly good individuals because they were pretty certain that they saw someone get shot a bunch, impossibly, and keep going.
Did they say what color the blood was, or if it ran?
They didn't see any blood. They shot him, and they know that they hit him in vital places, but there was no bleeding. Like, you'd think it may be a vest, but you've seen the guns these boys have, right? And he'll reach into one of his drawers and hold up a revolver. It's a pretty mean-looking gun, all things considered, and you know that that would hurt even through a bulletproof vest. This isn't the movies. If you shoot someone a lot of times with one of these, they're going to go down whether the bullets penetrate or not. Didn't happen. And you slam it down onto the table. Luckily, safety's on and it's not loaded at the point. Yeah, gun safety, kids. He slams it down onto the table. But no. We don't know what it was. I'll tell you what I can, but honestly, I was hoping you were going to come here with more information for us.
This was a fairly new event that I was only recently made aware of.
If you'd known about it longer than us, I'd be surprised. This happened 3 days ago.
We have come to ascertain what or and who this is and find them.
You gonna make them suffer for killing some of my boys?
If necessary, to
necessary
to do such a thing in the light is to expose us all. He will probably, or she, whoever it is, will probably be left to the mercies of others of our kind.
He, she, okay. At best, I can give you a description from one of the boys who were a little bit less shook up. The thing is, it's not a good description, and it's barely anything to go on. It's not even really gone into a report except to say that the guy was maybe 6 foot tall and was wearing a long coat. Heck, they don't even remember what his hairstyle was. Or
white,
color of his skin.
Black.
We don't even know the color of the skin. Which you'd think they'd remember that much. But no. Maybe they were probably pretty shook up about the guy that they shot not being dead.
You said tore apart, as in physically, or was he armed?
Well, he will sort of stand up and go to a cupboard at the back of the room. It looks like it's got a number of key locks, and he'll go through them. I happen to keep a little folder of the stuff that we aren't allowed to show to, you know, the uninitiated people. He just, like, he was already pale looking when you saw him. He pales even more when he reaches in and pulls out a folder. It looks quite new, and he'll drop it down onto the table between the two of you before returning to his seat. It would appear to be autopsy reports and full photographs, that kind of thing. The injuries on these people are consistent with, you know, you can make out fingerprints, almost, like, gripped hands on these people's limbs and tore them the fuck to shreds. Okay, let's see here. How much you fuckers know about biology, huh? Claire?
I have some in science.
Yep. Give me intelligence. And whatever else you want to throw into it. Yep, science. Medicine would be more helpful, but science will work to a degree. You're going to get a minus one modifier, though, because science itself doesn't directly apply to medicine. Timothy, do you have any skills that you would like to leverage?
I have neither of bias.
Let's see what you do. Is there a skill that you would like to apply to this situation? You've been provided an autopsy report.
Unless I could, like, use investigation, there's nothing but worth rolling.
Investigation is not unreasonable. Not for the autopsy report, but there is an attached, like, situation report, I suppose, is a good way to look at it. So you can review over that if you want to make a intelligence investigation.
Okay.
Okay. Alright, first of all, Claire, looking over the injuries, it would seem that somehow enough force was leveraged by main like strength, main grip, to wrench people's limbs from their sockets. It wouldn't have taken them long to bleed out at all, and it probably would have been excruciatingly painful, indeed. The kind of injuries you're looking at are beyond most people. Indeed, like, you're pretty sure Zaire would struggle to rip someone's arms clean off. Admittedly, he's more of a dexterous-based fighter, which is why you know this, but... Yeah, whoever did this is strong as fuck. You'd think maybe a werewolf could do that, but they wouldn't leave fingerprint marks, they would leave claw marks.
And highly unlikely for a ghoul to have that much strength.
Correct, yes. Ghouls don't progress along enough in order to do that. At least in general, but very, very unlikely a ghoul would be powerful enough to rip someone part apart.
So unless we have some sort of mutant super ghoul running around, it's something else.
Maybe you're dealing with a Wookiee. Yeah, but for all intents and purposes, what you're looking at is impossible for a human being, and is likely impossible for your average everyday ghoul, and is difficult at best for Kindred, and is probably not a werewolf. I can give you the process of elimination, but you don't have the information to know exactly what the hell is up.
All right.
Timothy, on looking over the actual report, this event, it happened... The sun will have been up for about 20 or so minutes, which is generally enough that a vampire would not be out in the open, what with the burning to death thing going. And the event sounds strange. Like, there were 5 policemen who essentially went to a building where they had heard that there was an assault ongoing. It was further down to the south. Apparently there had been, like, a gunshot previously, but then a lot of just screaming and fighting and furniture getting smashed, and then for a while it was completely quiet. That's when the police themselves arrived. They didn't directly arrive at an altercation, they apparently arrived afterwards. When they encountered an individual roughly 6 foot tall in a trench coat that they're pretty sure is male, there were 5 policemen sent, all heavily armed, because they believed they'd arrived at an armed altercation. And for some reason, all of the facts there are very, very spotty. That's the main standout point you can see. Like, the fact that they couldn't get a description is surprising. The fact that he killed a number of armed policemen and then still just opted to run away is surprising. There's a lot about this that doesn't make sense.
All right, is there anything else?
That's all I've got. I can give you the address of the crime scene.
That would be lovely, thank you.
It's there in the report, page 2. You'll be able to see it, Timothy.
Okay.
It is... I will put it over here. Do not want that in size 40 font. And there you go. It's definitely unusual. It's the best that I'm able to give you guys as clues. all the facts that you have been provided make very little sense.
I'm gonna assume he wants his file back.
Yes, I would like to put that back in the box.
Claire will put the photos back in the, I assume, manila folder.
Yep. The most manilaest of folders.
Yay!
And he will return the folder to its
box.
Well,
gang, looks like we got another mystery on our hands.
Oh boy, Scoob. This one sounds real scary.
We even have a talking animal now, so,
you
know.
You have
a mystery machine. You've got the tough guy. You've got the smart one. And then I don't remember the part about, like, the teacher and the thief, but, you know, it's okay. And then you're taking
out... We just threw out a couple of the more boring characters.
Yeah, of course. We need to replace them.
We kind of merged Shag and Fred to make Zaire.
I guess. That's sort of how that went down. I don't remember either of them having any kind of, like, Krav Maga knowledge, but, you know, whatever.
Just replace Fred's trap knowledge with...
with CQC.
If it works out in the end.
It all works out in the end.
If you say so.
Alright. Yeah, I can't really think of anything. Claire will thank him for his time and turn to leave.
Yep, he doesn't stop you or anything. You hear him putting his gun away back into his drawer again and leaning, his chair creaks. Anything?
Yeah, Tim's just gonna go as well. I don't really think of anything else either.
Yeah. Timothy, as you're leaving the door, the sergeant will speak up and go, "You know, we're not meant to see you guys coming around here directly all the time. It's a problem for all of us. I have to answer questions that are not easy to answer or lie about. If you could please stay out of our hair directly, we would appreciate it."
As much as possible, yes.
That's just super. Just settled back into his chair again, looking exhausted.
I would like to make an intercult roll to see if I can think of any creatures that at least I know of or heard about that can demonstrate similar abilities to us without, if this is anything other than what I, well, think slash hope this is.
Okay, intercult.
One success.
I mean, you could burn a willpower and then hope to just roll 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. That's not really
not?
A... No. I mean, like, if you roll a 10, you get to roll again. And then you get to roll again. You'd have to roll 10 many times to force that all the way up to a dramatic success.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah. I don't think you have the willpower necessary to swing that one, I'm afraid.
No, and I'm fine as long as it's not, like, a crit fail.
Fair. Okay. Things you would know about. It's not really common knowledge, like, things that go bump in the night, or things that go bump in the day, more likely. You know of things that go bump in the night, quite simply. You're one of them. Honestly, yeah, like, the easiest guess would have been it's a werewolf if it's a big, monstrously huge guy in the day. When I say monstrous huge, if it's a large person in the day. But, again, like, facts don't completely line up, and werewolves do bleed.
What about, what are they called? Homunculi, do they bleed? I can't remember if that guy bled all over the place or not.
He had blood, it was drained out of him by a device.
Oh, right, yeah, I remember now.
Homunculi are different, depending on whoever the fuck it is. Like, they're not a common case. Each of them is different special little snowflakes. They're a possibility.
My face went Promethean.
Yep. I mean, Promethean is a possible answer as well.
Alright, but does Claire know that?
I'll say with that, like, if you ask me a thing, I will try and give you a yes or no, or I'll give you information related to it. It's possible that you might understand Prometheans as being something that exists, but you have no data on that. But going entirely by myth and legend, it's not impossible.
So it's possible that this is Promethean, because Claire would know that as far as the Ordo knows, even the most powerful in her coil can only act as if their blood potency was one dot lower for the amount they can stay in daylight. They can't walk in daylight. Yeah. So 20 minutes, that'd still be way too long.
Yeah.
And you'd have been right deaded by that point.
Oh yeah, and I mean, the story wouldn't have been we didn't get his face. It's like, he ran away from us on fire and screaming.
Yeah. Well, even at that point, you only take aggravated damage, but it's still, lethal damage, not aggravated, but still, not good.
Yeah.
No. Although, if you have enough dots and resilience, apparently you can take fire damage down to bludgeoning. Bashing, I mean.
Oh, I'll have to look into that for making super vampires to kill you guys with later. I mean, yeah, no,
but
cool.
I think you'd still be sizzling, and they'd probably notice someone sizzling running away.
Yes.
Like bacon.
Yeah, I mean, even then, like 20 minutes is a long time. Even if it's reduced. Imagine taking consistently getting the shit beaten out of you for 20 straight minutes.
Yeah. 20 minutes of bashing damage, yeah.
Is going to turn into lethal, which is going to turn into aggro. No, this altercation happened in the street.
Oh, okay. I gotcha.
Yeah.
Alright. Claire's not... I think she'll just send a message to Antoinette saying that she highly doubts that this is a ghoul and is going to go investigate. Because she sounded busy, so she's going to send a message.
Yep. Yeah, you have no way... She does not respond immediately.
Yeah, not a ghoul. Probably not... That almost impossible to be a ghoul. Not a werewolf, and... that's about it. Impossible for a human on drugs, so.
Yep.
Very, very terse message.
Excellent. Terse is how she prefers it. Take out the negatives and don't come back to her with anything until you actually have an answer. It's the general way they like to run.
Alright, and with that, she'll turn to Timothy. I think we should investigate the area where this happened, but just to be safe, do you think we should pull in Zaire, or perhaps Rose, perhaps both, to aid in this, and having someone with considerable firepower and someone else who can, you know, enter a place discreetly would be of use when, has been of use for things like this in the past.
Is Zaire talking to you, then?
I tried to contact him, I think, once. Never responded to me, but I just kind of figured he was busy. It was not of anything of note. It's just something for the research I was doing.
Oh, I haven't seen him at all for a while. Starting to think he'd been avoiding me, to be honest. But you are right. It would perhaps be sensible to have assistance. Especially if we end up encountering this one.
Claire is also going to share what limited knowledge she has on what it might be for as far as Promethean goes.
Yep. As I say, like, you basically have legends.
I read it in a book, and so these things exist, but I have no idea what their powers are other than the fact that they could probably do this.
You have occult knowledge, Timothy. Do you want to give it intelligence occult?
Sure.
Do you want a dramatic failure, Timothy?
You know what? Sure.
What is a dramatic failure? Is it if... I thought it was like 1 to something for it to be a dramatic failure.
If you get no successes on a dice, just a failure, but you can opt to transfer it to a dramatic failure for a beat. Unless it's on a chance die, then it's always a dramatic failure and no beats.
Okay.
Okay, Timothy? Mull this over a little bit. Like, it's not the first time you've encountered them. Indeed, you've seen a homunculus before. You know that there are created creatures, and you have heard of Prometheans. You're pretty certain that they're not real. Let's have a look here. I think I might opt for inflicting you with a condition then, and get that one up and running, because that's always fun. Well, fun for me at the very least.
Okay.
Let's see here. There are so many to actually opt with that it's hard to say. Let's go with a mental state. Ooh, mental states. Fun times. I need to actually, like, grab the page with those fuckers on it, though. 277. There we go. Okay. Oh my god, I'm sure there's just a list of fucking conditions, and I cannot find them. I apologize. It is taking me a while. Here we go. You are distracted. Constant confusion and distractions will buffet you from all sides. Taking an extended action while you're trying to mull over this thing imposes a -2 penalty. This can be resolved by eventually coming to conclusions or figuring something out. Like, you're pretty sure it's not Prometheans and you can't figure out what it might be. And then until you've sort of got this mental puzzle off of you, you're going to be distracted. So trying to be perceptive while you're distracted imposes a -2 penalty. Usually trying to resolve distracted doesn't award a beat because it's more like an offensive condition. But for something like this, it will award a beat because you have to actually do something to figure it out.
Okie dokie. Promethean, Claire. Really? Is this the time for fairy stories?
Squint. I assure you, my research does point to them being real, and the Dracul has many such tales of such creatures. Good job, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
You're the best.
Mm. There you go.
Hmm?
I did it, guys. I gave someone a condition. I rock.
You did it! Yay!
I did it! Yeah! Conditions. Taking the hit for fat XP. That's how it's done. Okay. And now while you're all traveling to the altercation zone, you were going to contact.
Yeah, but I kind of figured it'd take long enough so their half hour of waiting would happen first.
Correct.
Or do we call them now?
We're gonna Batman transition symbol all the way back up to Rose and Zaire. Correct.
I'm gonna go grab a snack, so I'll be right back.
The Scooby snack?
Yep.
Meanwhile, in the mystery van.
I haven't had them until like 2 days ago, but Japanese peanuts are awesome.
Wasabi peanuts?
No. While I do like those, Japanese peanuts are peanuts that have like batter around the outside and then deep fried.
Oh, yes, yeah.
So they're like a crunchy cracker with a peanut inside. It's really good.
Yep.
But I left it in the other room.
Aww. Cracker nuts.
Is that what they're called?
Racist. It's our word.
I've had something like that. It's a very popular snack in the Philippines.
Yeah, makes sense. Anyway, yes. A half hour passes, no more, no less, exactly on the dot, when the door slides open. Is there anything that you guys did in there? In that interim 30 minutes?
I would be concentrating on hearing, like, anything.
Okay, then. Let's see here. You can do your wits perception check. Your wits composure, even.
I just don't want to be caught off guard.
Do you have a heightened sense for actually just listening specifically?
Nah.
No, okay.
Just a trained observer.
Yes. In this case, you're just doing listening. It's less a trained observer right now, and you're eavesdropping. So you won't
I'm observing with my ears.
It's, yeah, no, you're eavesdropping, which is technically a different thing. You still do wits composure, but you cannot do your special mind again, Mbaba. Likewise, Zaire, you are welcome to wits composure and try and listen in for info. If you have heightened senses that would work for hearing, you're allowed to use those.
Zaire.
DCL is muted. He's gone crazy at cracker nuts. That's what's up right now. I like that the owl knight's clothing changes color as well. I approve of Hoo Hoo, the wingman.
What's up going on?
Hey, dude.
There you are.
Oh, sorry.
Could you please do a wits composure?
Oh, yes, sorry.
Yeah, but specifically for your, like, you're in this contained booth, but you're able to, you know, like, listen out for shit over this half hour.
Just want to make sure that, you know, while we're sitting in this completely enclosed booth, nobody comes up and just unloads several machine guns into us.
That happened to me once.
Yeah, that would suck. Okay, so I'm going. You'll be relieved to find out that you do not hear bullets or bullets penetrating either of you. Is good. The sound of the music is uncomfortable and unsettling, but now that you've got like this space between you, like that overwhelming hunger appears to have stopped distracting you. I'll put it best. I guess it's hard to pick up on the atmosphere. Like, this booth that you're in feels almost like another world. Like, it doesn't do much to block out sound, but just by it being there, it sort of seems to separate you guys away from it. You can still listen, but conversation becomes a murmur. Like, sight, smell, like, all of those senses are kind of muted to you while you're in this boxy room. There's very little you can glean. You don't hear danger. You don't hear anyone being particularly loud. And you can, just before the door is opened, hear people, you know, walking up to it at the 30 minutes point. And so between the two of you, you can make out two sets of footsteps. So they won't surprise you by opening the door. You can be, you know, looking and ready like smart asses.
Okay. Well, Zaire changes none so ever since he's been sitting in pretty much formal attention the whole time.
Make small talk.
Yep. You ever see the latest episode of Game of Thrones?
So I finally found out why Jon Snow knew.
That was nothing. Yeah. Actually, you're a month behind on Game of Thrones now, DCL. Because you've been missing... You're missing a month's worth of knowledge. For all you know, you watched it, but don't remember.
Oh, does DC... Does Zaire mention this?
Well, I mean, I suppose that would have just come to him. I'm behind on Game of Thrones now. Zaire takes a moment to stop bodyguarding to be like shocked by this. I suppose I've had a rather busy month, but only just now hit me.
Well, you know, that's what the internet's for.
Wonderful. I don't fucking know.
It's true.
Really?
It's true.
Oh.
If this is like the current...
It is current year. So canonically, I guess it's not running right now.
Oh, okay.
So Zaire, you catch the new Westworld?
Westworld? What is the Westworld?
Well, you've been living under a rock?
It's a new TV show. You asked me that same question before. I live in my van.
Is it parked under a rock?
sometimes a very large rock. It's very safe.
I mean, sometimes I could offer a tactical advantage.
It's like Game of Thrones, if Game of Thrones were set in a futuristic dystopia where we make robots and then fucking kill them all the time.
So there's Jon Snow in it.
You know nothing, Zaire.
Was that a yes or a no?
No, there's not a Jon Snow.
And there's no Tyrion Lannister?
No.
So it's actually nothing like Game of Thrones.
But it's got Odin in it. You know, from the Marvel movies? Anthony Hopkins, that's his name.
So it's like nothing like Game of Thrones.
You know, all the stuff that made Game of Thrones awesome, like the pacing and the writing, it's got that.
But don't most shows have pacing and writing?
Good ones.
Well, I suppose I'll try to make it a time to watch it. I mean, your first recommendation, after all, pretty much took up so much time of just having to sit there and watch it. I feel a pang for once now that the season is over. When does it start up again?
Fuck if I know.
Zaire will make puppy dog eyes.
I mean, I could Google it.
The internet still confuses me. It's a very scary place.
There's a lot of lewd shit there, that's true. Full frontal hand-holding.
Zaire's virgin eyes cannot handle.
Suppose I'll excuse me.
Oh, I suppose that you will choke briefly.
Zaire, I'll look that up for you
later. Yeah, gonna hook him up with a torrent. Okay.
And yes,
yeah. Eventually, someone will arrive and. You were poked. Well, I say poked, like there's that, you know, that whole beast hackle sort of rubbing up against each other thing that happens? People's beasts. Again, like there's this sensation that someone is brushing up against you as though testing you. There's no push, there's no challenge involved. Like you're just, it's more like you've been recognized, I suppose. It's a very curious sensation, but they aren't trying to hide themselves. You suspect that they could have done if they wanted to. Like, this surety of power about whatever just reached out to you. It feels old, and it feels strong.
Oh boy.
Would either of you like to reach out and challenge the sensation?
The silence is a no.
Okay. Alright, always good to check. I would hate to, like, let you not take the opportunity to lash out at elder beings. Like, that would be a real shame.
I would hate to let you not miss up the chance of suicide via elder.
Yeah. Yeah, it's assisted suicide. But, you know. Okay. Yes.
Usually, it's suicide, you know, assisted suicide of the elders.
Yeah, usually. They're like, I'm getting a little bit too crazy. Push me. Push me to the sun. Do it.
No, I meant in real life.
Yeah, I know.
No.
But also when they get fucking crazy as shit in this setting.
Okay, yeah, I can hear somebody eating.
What?
I can hear you. I can hear you.
No. Was it like...
Yes.
That was just me squirting. Mio into my water. It's just me squirting into my water.
It's just you squirting. It's fine. No. Just a bit of squirting. Just a bit of squirting, bro. Just a prank, bro. Just a bit of squirt prank.
Just a bit of rape, bro.
Oh no. It's not cool.
Just a dick in your butt, bro.
Just
a
prank. Butt sex.
Yep. Okay. Anyway. The sort of door and curtain of this booth are opened and parted, and a woman will slip in. There is, say, like, there's a space for another person to sit down. Did you two sit opposite each other or next to each other?
Probably opposite.
Okay, then. That means this individual's going to sit down next to one of you. Rose.
Oh god.
This very sleek, elegantly dressed woman. She's got a huge number of piercings, like along her right ear, like a bunch of silver studs, starting from the top of the ear and working all their way down towards the lobe. Her hair is cut in a particularly, I guess, a punk angle, like the side of her head is shaved, but then the rest of her hair is sort of hanging quite long, dyed up in various purples, blacks, and blues. Typical gothy makeup as well. But her dress is very nice, almost a ball gown. And she'll smile, and I believe it would probably be... Yeah, Zaya, you might have been able to see her feet as she sort of slipped into place. She's wearing, like, army boots and shit. Like, you know, this woman is absurd and punky. And she'll smile at you both. Rose, she's close enough, she smells like... She smells like blood and of perfume of roses and lilies.
Roses and lilies.
You earned that one. That's right, you choke. You choke on your puns.
You're pun.
I'm pretty pun. Okay. She will look and go, I'm so glad we get to meet. You would be Miss Lawson, and you... Did you go missing? I had one of my friends looking for you quite recently. She'll look pointedly at you, Zaire.
Zaire doesn't know exactly what she's referring to, does he?
Well, I mean, she's saying that she immediately is like, oh, I know you, Rose, and she looks at you and seems confused that you're there and said, I thought you went missing. She apparently had tried to contact you at some point.
Oh. Zaire will dodge by saying, I was simply preoccupied with a job.
Usually someone being simply preoccupied doesn't take them entirely off of my radar, but I'll cede your point. Apparently very busy indeed. She'll give you a small smile. Originally I'd, reached out to Miss Lawson here. But I'm delighted that another neutral party would be coming along as well. I represent the Circle of the Crown. I know, not a very attractive name, but I suppose we're less politically bent and more about some of the more fun things in life. Challenge, maybe a bit of anarchy, admittedly. We find that the static ways of people are... Oh, so very bothersome, and you know what? I realize that I'm about to get into the spiel. I will skip on that. I have, I suppose, not so much a request as I would like a favor of you, of both of you, perhaps.
I was about to say something. Zaire will let Rose head the conversation.
Yes.
How much do you know of typical Kindred politics? I suspect that, considering you are both neutral parties, you're not exactly on the ground floor of such things.
I don't concern myself with such stuff.
Very well, then. What I'm about to tell you is for both of your ears only. Should you tell anyone else, we will absolutely kill you.
Before you tell us, why bother telling us then?
Because you might do something with this information.
Okay, so Zaire's gonna have to speak up here. He's gonna raise a hand and say, is this going to be information that implicates us into whatever you want without our consent?
She pauses. Actually, no. No, I mean, the other possibility is that you just do nothing with this information, and I'll have to find someone else.
Zaire will go back to silence.
Now then. As both of you may or may not know, the Prince awakens. In the new year, it is suspected by our experts that it will be New Year itself. Always did like a dramatic entrance, I suppose. However, this occurrence has decidedly worried a few other people. I mean, I'm hardly the prince's biggest fan. He is one of those very stuffy, rulesy types, and we never seem to mesh. But no, there is another group, though, who are, in my opinion, lacking in vision. They disagree with the prince, but for no good reasons, and sometimes it's the reasons that make things important. They are making synthetic blood.
Synthetic blood?
Yes. Synthetic blood. For us. For all of us, technically.
What is this, true blood now?
Zaire just kinda...
I don't watch shit television, dear.
It's also a series of shit novels, too.
Oh, wonderful. No, I've not consumed either of these medias.
Zaire just is kind of sitting here thinking about the implications of that with a confused look on his face. And eventually he'll say, is that necessarily a bad thing?
It's a very naive way of considering things. Consider this. The kindred no longer have to feed from the kine. What do you think actually happens at this point?
Wait, a kindred no longer... You said, out of character, you said kindred no longer...
No longer having to feed from the kind. Vampires no longer having to eat humans.
I forgot the kind was what we called humans.
Yeah, K-H-I-N-E, the kind as in the cattle.
Oh, K-I-N-E.
K-I-N-E, sorry.
I mean, they no longer have to. I assume there will be many vampires who will still prefer the real thing. And would simply indulge in self due to hunteral instincts.
Presumably.
I'm guessing what happens then is when
Rose stopped dying.
Sorry.
Rose inhaled a bee. A whole bee. The bees.
Shouldn't have whole bees.
Turned into fucking a lowland Persian.
Oh no, his face is so big.
Yippee. I would assume what would happen then is we no longer need the humans.
Ah, there you're catching on. And the Carthians, they are not big fans of our dependence on the kine, and in general aren't fans of the masquerade of playing the lie. And the lie is part of the game, and that's fun. The Circle of the Crone, we're all together with an anarchist kindred society, but the masquerade's an important part of that.
Seems awful generalized.
Yes, and I mean neither of you are politically involved enough for me to use anything other than generalized terms.
Zaire will shrug. Fair enough.
So what do you want us to do about it? Like you said, we're not politically inclined.
Correct, but I'm hoping that you're profitably inclined. For one, just because of my disagreements with the prince, I cannot be seen directly, nor can my people be seen directly as doing something to help him. That wouldn't fly, it would ruin our image, and our image is a hard enough one to maintain as it is. However, paying unaffiliated people to put together their own group or task to dismantle such a thing would be very profitable. And it would be out of our hands. Of course, you could just choose not to use this information or do anything about it. It increases our struggles, but I want you to be aware that it's unlikely we're going to do anything about this.
Okay, so out of character, does Zaire know, would Zaire have any knowledge of why vampires need to feed on kind. Absolutely.
Well, okay, you need to live. It's vitae.
I know, I mean, besides that, like, is there any important political and sociological structures that would be, like, completely disrupted if vampires just didn't need to feed on humans? Which I'm still of the opinion of, even with fake blood, they would still feed on humans.
Some, no doubt, would still feed on humans. They enjoy it and all of that stuff. In general, though, if fucking vampires never had to feed off of humans, you could... No, you don't have the political knowledge to know what would happen, exactly. Like, just judging by your own assumptions, what she's saying makes sense. Like, fucking, you wouldn't need humans. It would definitely start fighting, because there would be disagreements. And that would fuck with the masquerade alone.
Because, I mean, if anything, this would only help keep the masquerade up. So...
You wouldn't need it.
I'm not sure I agree.
Agree with what? That this is a bad thing, or that would help keep the masquerade up?
Both.
Hmm. Please do say, what are your feelings on the matters,
Zaya? I haven't been a vampire long.
Correct.
I haven't gotten my head around this whole eternity thing.
Yes.
But it seems to me the whole masquerade thing, it's not there to protect humans.
Oh, goodness,
it's there to protect us.
It is there to protect us.
If some stupid idiots suddenly decided we don't need humans, so let's just kill them all, I don't imagine them getting very far.
Well, that's the thing. I am speaking in generalized terms, and sadly I'm not privy to the full information. I do not know why they would entirely give up on the masquerade, but that seems to be the direction that they are tending in towards. There is a lot that we don't know because I cannot invest my people too deeply.
I mean, if you want information...
It would certainly be a start. And it would pay.
I could probably... No, I won't say probably. I could consider such a job.
Yes, breaking into a few laboratories, maybe trying to get into a few,
casing a few joints, tailing some people.
Indeed, yes.
It's all pretty standard stuff.
Well, it's mostly
dismantling dismantling some kind of manufactory. That's way above my pay grade.
Only if you lack a little bit of ingenuity, I suppose. But yes, gathering information would certainly be a good start, and it would pay money. I could even have one of my people draft you up a few ideal locations, I suppose. We have the pre-legwork done, but we are not investing in actual performing.
So I was keeping silent on this one.
Say that last thing again.
Is it Zaya's
not
keeping
silent?
Her people have, like, they know places to go to get information, but she has not allowed any of her people to do that legwork. They are not allowed to do it. They're not allowed to be seen as being invested in it. But, I mean, if she has those locations ready to go, she's happy to pass them on to you if you are willing to go and get the information. That said, I will not be giving you this unless you agree to actually go and gather the information.
I can't guarantee how much information we can secure, but if this is just a job like any other...
I suppose it is at the end of the day.
I am for hire, then.
That's his
As for Zaire, I can't speak for him. I only brought him here to watch my back.
That is fair. Mr. Alte, what are your takes on a little bit of independent party work?
I'm normally here just simply to protect my friends. I don't shy away from jobs, but information gathering is not really my specialty. Not unless it involves gathering information at the end of a barrel of a gun.
She taps a finger pointedly on the little table.
We may have the kind of work that's within your realm of expertise, then.
Slow lift of the eyebrow over the shade.
How confident are you in your combat abilities?
Confidence is not a matter of question, but my time is at the moment. I may be busy with certain things.
Would these be the same certain things that have had you disappearing on and off the radar for the past month?
That's a safe assumption.
See, I see. Very well, I suppose I can't force your hand on the matter, but there are a few individuals of no mean strength whose absence from this world would improve everyone's lives just a little bit.
I generally do not like to get into politicking factors, but if you can convince me with reason beyond a doubt that killing these people would be the benefit for kind, kindred, everywhere, then I suppose I'd be inclined to take them.
Very well, then. Are you still living out of your van, or do you have a permanent address at which I could possibly have some dossiers dropped off?
Still in the van, he says without a hint of shame.
She'll pause and, like, glance to her left at Rose as though, like, is this guy for real?
Apologetic shrug.
She'll nod slightly.
Very well, though it pains me to do so, I'll have one of my agents be made available at the Elysium. You just have to speak to him, and he'll be able to pass on dossiers to you directly, I suppose.
Zaire will not.
And now I suppose it's all well and good that I've made these requests of you and put this information out here. Would you like to ask me anything? I suppose that's a fair way for information to go.
Well, I guess my obvious question is, why were you trying to keep such a close tab on me during the last month?
I suppose it burrows again into politics, but an unaffiliated factor is as much an interesting one as it is a dangerous one. Maybe you wouldn't understand, but it's for reasons like being able to make independent offers to someone that someone is considered dangerous. If, for instance, someone were to find out that the Circle of the Crone were trying to get you to do something against the Carthians, that would be bad for everyone.
I do understand and I don't understand.
Let us put it this way. A tool has no ownership of itself. It can be wielded. Once you join a group, though, you have a label.
I mean, I understand that part, but I thought I made it clear from my reputation that I disdain from being involved in politics or starting anything that is would be considered infighting.
Indeed, but that just means that I get to know that you are a tool who is always going to remain an aspect of neutrality, which is why we wanted to keep contact with you and keep tabs on you. You're a valuable resource, Mr. Alte.
Zaire just kind of frowns and says, like, as long as we're...
I can assure you that we're definitely not the only ones keeping tabs on you.
Hmm.
And indeed, we're not the only ones to have been perplexed by your sudden disappearance, actually.
There's been talk of my disappearance?
Amongst the correct circles, I suppose, yes.
Zaire, I guess I don't have to go out of my way to tell you I don't really like this.
It's not a question of liking or not, dear. She seems incredibly amused by this concept.
I just don't fully grasp it. I am still a young vampire. There should be nobody who really cares about my going-ons.
You're a free weapon, Mr. Alty.
Surely you can't be that.
That is exceptionally rare. Usually when someone is made a vampire, they are brought in to the orders from which their sires belonged. Someone coming out of nowhere with no affiliations is as rare as I'm making it sound. There are perhaps three others I can think of that are neutral, not including yourselves and Miss Lawson.
I suppose I can understand why people are so interested in me.
Indeed. I'm sure your friend as well, the bartender's underling, Mr. Lee, has run the old Ordo spiel, and I'm sure it was as delightfully dull as it always is. They always do run the same pamphlet.
Invictus.
Pamphlet.
I've been made offers through many groups. I've declined them all.
Good, and that is why I'm delighted to be speaking with you and seeing that you are still in one piece.
Well, I guess that's the only question I had. And you'll remain silent for Rose to speak.
Miss Lawson, is there anything you would like to ask or request? She gives you a mildly sultry smile.
And next time, when I drop off a package, actual neutral ground.
Of course. Do you have a preference for location, assuming it's not the Elysium itself?
Some kind of park. Public, open. Not.
Just not generally to our style, but okay, we can acquiesce for this. She'll give you a small smile.
Good. I have to deal with dogs. I'll be right back.
Sure thing. Gotta settle all them books down.
Like curiosity, can I feel the tether of Madame Hoots?
Whenever you try to concentrate on her, yeah, it's like a tugging in a direction.
I wonder, can I share any information between her and between her and me?
How do you intend to try?
No idea. I'd have to feel around since I have no idea how this works.
Okay, let's have a look here. I need to find out. Okay, because it's entirely possible.
But if I can have a literal adorable eye in the sky constantly flies overhead to give me information, that'd be like a huge tactical advantage.
It would. Okay, let's see here. You can speak mind to mind with her if you sort of reach out and then make it obvious you want to talk, like, you know, the sensation, like, I want to make conference. Madame Hoots has to speak first, but you can hear her and then respond in kind.
Huh. Well, for now, I'll keep cuts high, because all I wanted to do was check to see if the link even worked.
Yes, it does. When you reach out, give the cord a tug, essentially, you can sense that she is somewhere present. Can you give me a chance die, please?
All right. So close,
it's so far away. Yep, just reach out and she is present out there somewhere. Not too far from you. But also not as close as she usually is.
Understandably.
we'll just wait for Lily to come back, because she will do one last thing before you are allowed to escape away.
Escape.
Escape.
Okay, I am back.
Welcome back.
You're getting ready to escape.
Yep. Okay, so, Rose.
Yes, let us away.
Yes, but just before you're able to slip away, though, the Elder is between you and the way out of the little booth, and she will reach out with a single finger and would intend to run it down your cheek.
Yeah, no. I'm gonna back.
I just wanted to ask about that curious eye of yours.
It was, accident.
You wanna give me a wits manipulation there for your lion?
You happen to do
sorry, what? Somebody was talking to me.
Yep. Can I have a wits manipulation for lying?
I will say that it happened during an accident, you know. Sexy time gone wrong.
There is no good way to interpret that.
There isn't really.
Manipulation and
wits.
Well,
okay.
Subterfuge.
Oh yeah. Okay. Subterfuge. Manipulation. Sorry.
I mean, wits would be.
Wits would actually be beneficial to you, but no, you're right. It's subterfuge. Should have stayed quiet, you fool.
Wits and subterfuge.
No. Oh fuck, okay. She doesn't seem to she suspects that there is slightly more to this story by the look on her face, but apparently not to enough of a degree where she'll press you on the matter. Very well then, I suppose I'll have to scoot out. You two, please do take care of yourselves. It's getting dangerous out there.
Of course. There wouldn't be much point of me being here if there was danger.
Yeah. I don't know, Rose, is something you might have heard before. You're pretty sure that that is some kind of coded phrase or a cryptic warning.
Yeah.
Hide the cryptic warning. In a very blatant warning.
That's in like the same vein as, you know, nice whatever you've got there. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to it.
Yeah, it's not a far off way to put it. You don't suspect she's warning you about her, I suppose.
I mean, we suppose.
Saying something's gonna go down though.
She is saying that something is gonna go down.
It's about to go down.
Chose like the two most unaffiliated people who are gonna do nothing with this.
Well, no, I mean, she's offered you work for money to go to a place, so
that too, but
she had two lines of inquiry, and literally the second one was if they didn't seem too amenable to a little bit of if you didn't seem amenable to a little bit of internal struggles, then the second option was pay them to do work then. That's actually okay. That works fine. But, you know, she would definitely try to play the angle before offering money. It'd be crazy not to. Yes, no. She leaves you that little cryptic warning and then slips out first when the door parts away and the curtain pulls. The pounding of bass tunes is once again live and throbbing in the air. It is at this point, Zaire, that you get a little phone call.
Again.
Let's get out of here.
All right. Well, Zaire will try to answer the phone. After he'll try to rush outside so that way he can actually hear.
Yep, sure. Okay then. Timothy, it takes a few rings to get through to Zaire. And once you do, you can hear like pounding notes out, like just in the background. Like it's hard to hear him clearly. Sounds like he's at the club.
Party, Zaire?
Oh, Timothy. It's a long story, to be fair.
I don't mind. Where have you been this past month?
That is also a bit of a long story.
Fair enough. Listen. Claire and I are investigating something that happened a couple of days ago, and it might be a little dangerous.
Zaire's already internally cursing.
So I was hoping that you might be willing to come and help.
Is it going to be M19 handgun dangerous, or A4 assault rifles dangerous?
Tim will speak a little more quietly in case there are people around. I know it's night, but sort of tearing police officers literally limb from limb. Dangerous.
Ooh. The kind of danger I specialize in. Zaire will kind of look up to the sky, to the owl he can't see, and think about all the things he needs to be done, but he's ultimately going to agree. So it's just like, I suppose I can come back and help you with this. I do owe you and my friends for being gone for at least a month.
All right. Thank you. Yep. Long shot, but I don't suppose Rose is with you.
It's a long shot that hit its mark.
Saves a second call, at least.
If Rose is next to me, I guess I'll tap her and put her on the phone.
Sure, I take it by this point, like you're like out front of the church, yes?
Shouldn't we get out of here before we start talking? Hello, who is this?
Rose, it's Tim. Claire and I.
Bad time, but what's up?
Apologies. Claire and I are looking into something. You might be helpful, but if you do have business, please don't let us intrude. Though I am. We'll have to borrow Zaire.
That's fine. I'm done with him.
All right.
As long as he can drop me back off at my bike.
That is a long journey. That is a long round trip for poor Zaire. I don't know that he'll have enough time in the day.
Well, the thing...
He'll have plenty of time in the night.
But Antish.
They did say that they went to this place because of hearing violence within a building, right?
Correct, yes.
Yeah, so it's not that she would maybe be useful. She would definitely be useful if, you know, the door's locked and we need to get in. Otherwise, it's probably just going to end up asking Zaire to please remove the doorknob.
Zaire will oblige and said removal of knobs.
It would not be the first knob Zaire has severed.
Nor will it be the last.
I mean, I imagine Tim is right next to Claire if she wanted to just lean in and say that over the phone before he hangs up.
Yeah, sure, she'll have said that.
Well, then Rose will have heard that request.
What now?
You will have heard Claire going like, it would be nice to have Rose along, seeing like break into locked rooms and stuff.
Why can't I just watch shows? Occasionally break into shit. Why now, all of a sudden? Why now?
Because the world is active and it needs you once again, gentle kindred.
Fine. Guess I'll come along.
Grumpiest member of the...
Such a reluctant hero. So reluctant.
Zaire gives Rose a smile and is like, do not worry. I'll buy you pancakes on the way.
What? What do I need pancakes for? I can't eat them.
Pancakes make everything better.
Not if you can't eat them.
Wait, can vampires just straight up not eat food?
You can burn a blush of life to eat food, but unless you burn it for long enough to digest it, then you'll have to throw it up. So it's like a really big vitae investment for most kindred if you want to actually eat a meal.
But it's pancakes. It's completely worth it.
Actually, I mean, I guess unless you're Claire, who can just burn a vitae, be blushed up all day, and eat the pancakes
well,
she wants.
I can just use it for a scene. I don't have to burning. I thought burning vitae was for.
There's no scene that's going to cover you eating pancakes and then digesting them over the course of a day. No scene is that long.
Once I activate it, it's up for 24 hours. It's fine. I'm great.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, in Claire's case, 24 hours, that's fine. You can activate Blush of Life and not give a shit for the entire day. You can eat all the pancakes you want. One vitae, bam.
Except, no matter what, pancakes gotta go somewhere.
It does.
Vampires don't poop.
Do they not at all?
It's coming up, somehow. I'm pretty sure.
I'm pretty sure if you have Blush of Life on for the entire duration, then you're fine. Like, you will digest. It's, the idea is that you'll usually have to throw it up because no one has Blush of Life on for long enough to digest food and let it run their whole system.
If you're sure.
I mean, I'm saying that's the case, so, you know.
Okay.
There you go. Okay. Because otherwise we start reaching into nightmare territory that none of us really wants to decide.
Vampire primer, nobody poops.
Everyone poops but you. You're a vampire. You're a very naughty boy, and that's concentrated evil coming out of you. There we go. Okay. Yeah, no. Naturally, though, Rose is probably not bribable with pancakes. Anyway, so it's not as long of a drive straight down to, I guess, are you meeting at the altercation or are you meeting at the police station?
I assume just the altercation, right?
Yeah.
Alright.
I guess, wait, where are they at this point? They're still...
They're at the Hail Mary over here.
Okay, and we're at the police station. So get there first so we can, like, scout things out.
All right then, Rose, you're given an address and it's attached to the main street. From like turning a corner, you can basically do a straight shot down to where you need to go. Well, Miss Rose, I mean Zaire, because he's driving, presumably.
Yep. Zaire shall do so.
You see, for the first, probably like for the first time, completely. Well, no, you would have been in her, the car, been in the car with her the whole time. Is, you know, Zaire's companion.
Oh yeah, one more thing. Zaire will definitely mention on the road that the matter of the owl that I showed you, I did show it to you because I thought you would be best for keeping a secret. So would you mind not telling any of the group about
it? You sure? Like, Claire would probably be able to figure something out about it.
She would, but I don't think that would be a wise idea.
Yeah, you hear like a... like winds whistling ominously in the background.
I guess.
Pinky promise.
Pinky swear.
Zaire, actually, now that you mention it, Zaire will hold out his pinky.
You're kidding me.
Nobody breaks a pinky promise.
Just the most blank look.
Zaire still has the most expectant look in holding up his pinky while driving. The most reluctant hero.
Woot.
Fine.
Zaire will smile as he gets his pinky promise.
Hey, Hey, Rose, can you give me a wits composure with trained observer, please?
I can. Yes, I will, because I have no reason not to.
I mean, you could choose not to. That's fine. Nothing bad will happen.
Choose to ignore.
Boom!
Son of a fucking bitch. Nice. Every time I'm like, yeah, this would be an interesting thing to be, put a sneaker in. That's the time whenever anyone fucking nails it. Ugh. Okay. When DCL specifically mentioned not mentioning the owl to the others, like, it was almost as though it were just a movement of the trees, but you saw, like, a fucking bunch of owls. Like, a bunch of them in this tree. Like, a ton of them, and they all sort of flapped away in different directions. It would be a normal thing for, like, birds to scatter out of a tree, but it's, like, the one tree in this area, and they're all relatively large-sized owls, and they all just fucking peace out.
Then right before I pinky swear, I'm gonna cross my other fingers.
Excellent. Okay. Alright then. It's about a 20-minute drive down. Let's see here. You were in there for half an hour. It was half 20 there. So it's about 3:15 when you get to where the altercation happened. However, Timothy and Claire will have already gotten there first. Would you like to do your checks? Or, like, casing the joint, I can happily describe the place to you, but if you would like to throw dice at something before I lead on with information.
I would like to throw my 9-again dice at it.
Yeah, I said to Timothy and Claire first, they're going to be there before you.
Damn.
Yeah, perception's probably a good idea. I assume this counts as one of those things distracted goes against.
Correct. Unfortunate.
Most unfortunate.
On the plus side, once you get distracted dealt with, you'll get a free beat. Well, free beat. You'll get a beat.
Why are they distracted?
Yeah. He's currently dealing with a mental conundrum, and his mind palace is currently is just busy. He's got an occupied mind palace right now.
Okay.
Ooh, Irish coffee. I'm gonna fucking hook myself up with some of that later.
I do like some Irish coffee, but typically I hold the coffee.
Take the Irish.
Hey, oh, yeah. It's cold. It's pretty nippy out here, so.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Well, I'm in the garage, so.
Yeah. All right. Can you give me a wits composure or any other dice you would like to try and throw at this situation, Claire? You are the first ones to arrive at the location.
Yeah, I'll do wits composure. Nope.
Okay. It's a street like many you've seen before. Like, you're closer to where a lot of the, I suppose the Mexican population has ended up in this area. It's pretty reasonably maintained, but just there's a different style about most of the buildings here. A lot of foreign catering shops. Probably the only place you can get Mexican Coca-Cola. Which I hear in America is a big deal because they use sugar and the rest of fucking America doesn't, apparently.
Oh, yeah. It's like high fructose corn syrup. It's gross.
Yeah. So, I mean, if you want to get real Coca-Cola, this would be the place to do it. Regardless. I mean, actually, that would be, you know, that would be a nice gift for Etienne there, Lily. Pick her up some Mexican Coke.
Yeah.
The drug or the drink?
Both.
I was expecting the both.
The drink.
The drink. Yeah, there are corner shops. Real sugar Coca-Cola.
Not that I know anything about it.
I could just stop at a Home Depot.
Oh, I get. Oh.
No, actually, like Home Depots will sell those.
Oh, I thought that was just a racist joke. Like,
no. They might sell them for racist reasons.
Oh, that's true. Oh, that's unfortunate right there.
Like,
I took that to a dark place.
My local Home Depots will sell those, like, glass bottles of Coke and Sprite and all that.
Very nice. You got us, okay. It is a very normal-looking block besides, like, the more, I guess, cultural differences. It's not massively different. It's a relatively run-down area. It's not where you would have very expensive housing, let's put it that way. Where the original cohabitation happened, there is a, like, apartment block, two floors of your American floors, where it's just two stories, there's no ground floor for some reason.
I mean, why would you count? I mean, of course you count the ground one.
I don't want to get into this darkness. It's two stories of apartment, probably made up of four rooms, two on the bottom, two on the top.
We've had this discussion before.
Yeah, there is police tape in front of the frontmost building, and there is evidence of, like, cracks in the pavement, like, right outside the door. Yeah, that's what you see at your first look around.
I mean, all I'm going to say to the floor situation is Brexit.
What?
Cock.
Okay.
So help me, I'll put him in this game. You realize that, right?
I'm trying to make a stupid joke and nobody bit it.
Nope. Nope.
Everyone's just like, okay.
Nope. Yep, moving on. So just filing my nails. Terrible person. Okay, so yes, as I say, like, you didn't really spot anything stand out or strange on your arrival. Is Timothy facing in the crowd, by the way?
Yep.
Excellent. Okay. Alright. Rose, Zaire, you guys arrive early. Well, sorry, not early, but after is the word I was looking for instead of the word early. Long sleep here. You arrive after this by about 10 minutes. It was a quiet drive. You're reaching the 3 a.m. hours where it finally does get a bit quieter. It'll be busy again the moment 5 hits, but now you're in sort of that 2-hour grace where shit's generally more peaceful. You're out on a main street, so it's quite well lit out here, and now both of you two are also welcome to do wits composure rolls.
Okay. So.
Where's the art?
The art. Wow.
Wow.
You got a zero.
I'm the only one who didn't get a zero.
So disappointed. Zaya carrying the team. Okay.
I'll take a beat.
You'll take a beat? I didn't offer you a beat. I have to offer you a dramatic failure. There is.
Do you have to?
I believe I have to offer you a dramatic failure.
Oh.
Yeah. Unless it's one where it's a, like, you can choose to take on a fitting condition. If you can think up one, then yeah, I'll let you take that as opposed to a beat.
Damn.
You know, that's the thing I have to offer you, because there are just going to be situations where failing, I haven't got anything that can fuck you over. And I can only throw so many imaginary enemies at someone before it just slows everything down. Don't get me wrong, I do love my imaginary enemies, but they do slow things down a smidge. So, Zaire.
Yep.
When you all arrive, Rose is looking around and just she must be off her game or something, because you're the first one to notice that there are signs of blood being washed off the floor, specifically around where there are cracks. And also, like, on the corner or outside by this police tape. Are your friends Timmy and Claire?
Just look like a super sloppy job.
Well, at least Claire is there.
Yeah, actually, that's a good point. You can't see Timmy. His face is in the crowd right now.
Hmm. Zaire will mention the blood to the group.
The blood?
The blood. There's blood on the floor that looks like it's been poorly washed away around a bunch of the cracks. There's more details, but I wanted you guys meeting each other to happen first. Like, you know, just get that discussion-y stuff out of the way, because it'd be really weird for Zaire to turn up, not say hello to Claire or Tim, case the joint, and then be like, oh, by the way, hi.
That's what I thought was happening.
Yeah, exactly. Like, I was like, wait, this could actually get pretty fucking weird. So this was like, things you notice at first. And it's like, you also notice your friends. You should probably say hi to them before I continue describing shit to you.
Alright. And Zaire gets out the car, and he shall go to start saying hello to his friends.
Ah, Zaire. Long time no see.
For me, it feels like it's only been a day.
Been busy, have you? I know that feeling. I'm pretty sure out of everyone, Claire would understand the most. Just, oh man, I got this new load of books. It's 2 months later? What?
Actually, this is a good idea that I haven't been doing yet. What's the role to observe somebody again?
What, to like understand someone else?
Like, if I wanted to do a quick Sherlock glance over
their Sherlock box, scan?
Yeah, a quick Sherlock scan, what would it be?
You've done it before. It's wit's empathy.
Okay. Yeah. I want to look at Claire.
Okay. Just
glancing over to see if anything's different.
Feel free to describe anything that may have altered Claire's emotional state.
Well, I mean, since last... I think the last time we were all hanging out together was when she was getting Herrera back, right?
Yep.
Yeah, she looks like she has a burden lifter off of her shoulders, and she, she's on a case for research. She looks fairly pleased with the arrangement so far.
All right. So that's Zaire's happy about that. That's one person who's done well within the last month. And because I forgot to do this, I'll do this now for Rose.
Hey, you keep your Cumberbatch eyes off me.
Yeah, it's all bendy dick coming to buns.
That's an interesting nickname for him.
All right, likewise there.
Better draw Cabbage Patch.
Yeah, likewise, Lily, you can give him the basics of your emotional state.
Fidgety, annoyed.
Fair enough.
That's usual.
Yep.
I guess nothing as much.
A little bit more so than usual.
Oh.
Would you say rattled, perhaps?
Rattled, yeah.
I was gonna go home and watch a cartoon!
More like I was gonna fucking masturbate all the nervousness out of me, because I think we were nearly gonna get killed in a booth in a creepy church club.
Definitely more so, like, annoyed.
Aye.
That is also a typical Rose trait.
Okay. And then turning attentions back to this building. The police tape. Zaire, you think it's been moved recently. Like, you know, someone has untaped it and retaped it.
I will bring all these factors up to everybody. Because shit's weird, yo.
Crinkle, crinkle.
Has anybody else noticed that the bloodstains of the police tape has been...
I didn't hear you cut out. Has been what?
Your microphone cut a couple of times there.
Damn it. I hope my mic is not done. I don't have the money for a new one.
No, it's probably a Discord setting. I had to fix that a bit ago myself.
It's probably this headset, though. something disconnected on my computer. But yeah, did anybody else notice the blood on the floor or the fact that the police tape looks like it's been undone and redone?
I had not. Good eye.
Zaire kind of scratches his head, confused that nobody noticed, but says nothing.
Probably just the cleaning job was rushed a little.
Seems so. Hmm. Oh, wait. Zaire will kind of like double take and just notice that Timothy was here because of facing the crowd. Go, like, oh, there you are.
Yes, I've been here for. Oh, right. Sorry. I'm thinking about things.
And then, of course.
Benedict, he looks distracted. I can tell you that before you even get to see, hear the basics. Timothy looks distracted.
Tim had been reading too many Batman comics before he got sired. As soon as he learned he could face in the crowd, man, he does that all the time.
So when people turn around, they've done the Batman and they're not there anymore. Damn it!
I'm Batvamp.
I'm Timmy.
Timmy!
Oh no, before we spiral further into the heart of madness. That is an excellent use of face in the crowd, though.
It really is.
I always knew that Batman was a specialist in obtenebration and obfuscation.
I always knew that Batman was a vampire.
I didn't think I sounded all rednecky and shit, but sure. Oh, Derek, gosh darn it, I always knew that Batman was a vampire.
They done took our jobs.
Yeah, fucking Batman took our jobs. Batman.
Well, he is Bat. The guy vampire bats. Makes sense, really.
Yeah, I bet they're the reason our crops going bad. It's them vampire bats been vampirizing them crops.
You ever see Batman flying through the skies during the day?
And then you got them damn fruit bats.
And you're eating her fruit. There's no fruit in America. You have corn and pretend sugar.
Oh, we have plenty of fruit. Look at San Francisco.
That's the joke I was trying to make, damn it. That was the joke I was trying to make.
I will not lie. Go to the French Quarter. In fact, the old army fort got taken over by an LGBT porn studio, and they have like rainbow flags going off it all the time. It's great. I love it.
That sounds pretty cool.
That was the joke I was trying to make, and nobody got it. I was like, damn it.
Oh, well. We got there in the end, though. We made it. And now I want to invent an LGBT castle. Oh well.
It was a army military fort. Yeah, hang on, I got a picture.
Okay,
Just go in Fallout 4 and put up some LGBT flags on the castle.
Yeah, absolutely. The gayest fort.
I guess I should mention now, have any of you been watching Yaoi on Ice?
No.
Even though the title is Yuri on Ice, it's completely Yaoi on Ice because it's gay as shit.
No.
I don't watch anime.
Yuri is gay.
It is, yeah. It's just different gay.
I mean, it is, but...
Is it Hadou gay?
It's Yaoi. No.
Is it Razor Ramon hard gay?
No. But it's a good anime, and I'm surprised nobody else here is watching it.
What about the butt battle anime?
I mean, I'm still watching that. I'm not surprised nobody but me is watching.
He liked a butt. He liked it thick.
It's like the only anime that I've been like, maybe I should watch that.
I'm watching it purely because of the ability. It has way too much effort put into it for what it is, and I kind of like that.
Yeah, I just don't really watch anime.
Damn it. Okay, I'm the only weeb here.
Alright, anyway, are you guys going into this fucking building?
Yeah, that's in the French Quarter in San Francisco. They have a really, really good BDSM bar in there.
I mean, I've seen porn with that, like, little castle as a logo thing.
Yep, that's the studio. The entire thing is a porn studio.
That is a huge-ass porn studio.
Oh, yeah.
They shoot a lot of shit there. Oh, yeah.
They shoot lots of shit at the porn studio, the gay porn studio, do they? I mean, no.
Yeah, the tour is pretty cool. And then at the end of the tour, if you go on the tour, you get a free drink at the BDSM bar. It's cool.
Only a drink? Oh.
A quote-unquote drink.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Yeah, don't trust the bathrooms, though. Be careful. Keep it clean.
Actually, their restrooms were pretty nice.
I was going to say, actually, they're all gay, so they're going to be really clean. They're going to be pleasant.
There was a, the urinal was a water fountain. It was like each one was its own little water fountain thing. It was weird, but also kind of cool.
Yep, okay. Anyway, moving on, or we'll be here all fucking night. I want to wrap up this place before we're done for the evening. Are y'all fuckers going in?
I mean, first, so. But.
Rose, don't suppose you spy any ghosts?
Sorry, what?
Do you spy with your little eye?
Any ghosts?
I want to take a look around.
Okie dokie. Alright. You do notice a ghost. Or more obviously, there are ghosts around, but there is one that stands out because it is in police uniform. It's just sort of sat on the stairs leading up to the apartment, in fact.
Hey, officer.
Nigga got roasted.
At first he doesn't seem to notice that you're calling out to him. I think he's just sort of got a bit of a 1,000-yard stare thing going on.
You there, point at him.
Yep. He'll pause and go, ma'am, can I help you with something?
Something, happen here? Like, some kind of violent altercation?
Yeah, we just actually came here a few moments ago to, wait. And then he looks confused for a second. There's, like, a flickering in his image. Right. Yeah, there was. I think I got killed. I'm dead, aren't I?
Yeah. You're a ghost.
That would explain why you're so funny looking. There was definitely some violence here. I think recently.
I believe my friend here has some questions for you.
Which one?
Point to Tim.
Right.
He is sort of the lead investigator on this case.
Oh, we had to get outside help, huh? I'm not surprised. One of our best died. Sure, ask away, son. And he'll, like, look to Timothy, not aware that Timothy probably can't hear that question. That the street itself is lit by a lamp, so.
You can feel free to ask him. Whatever.
All right. Can you remember anything about the thing you were fighting?
Fighting? I mean, we didn't have much of a chance to fight. At least, I know I didn't. I don't know what happened to the others or how many of them made it, actually. I mean, I'm the only ghost, so God willing, I'm the only one who dared. But, yeah, there was a big fella in a coat. He came bursting out of that door, and he'll jerk a thumb over his shoulder. And I was the first one at the door, and before I could even draw a gun or shout or say anything, I don't remember. I know I died, but I don't remember how.
I will relay this.
Tim, you know for a fact that multiple people died. It just happens to be that he's the only ghost.
Alright. Any actual description beyond tall trench coat.
I didn't get a good look at the man. He were a black fella, and...
Zaire will suddenly cough.
You don't even know why you're coughing. You can't hear it.
No, he doesn't know why. He just...
Actually, yeah, when Zaire coughs, he blinks and goes, "Actually, looks a lot like that, son of a bitch."
You bothered to draw breath to cough?
That's a good point, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I imagine, like, unless you get down at the low humanity levels, breathing is still pretty natural.
You still keep that involuntary reflex, even if you're not blushing of life?
Yeah, sure. You don't need to do it, but also at the same time, since muscle reflex being what it is, it probably still happens.
And, okay. You know, if you need it for speaking. Talking,
yeah, you need it for talking, so it would make sense to keep doing it.
Yeah, that's true.
It's just natural, and, like, I mean, the low humanity levels, you start to, you know, be more not human, so. Yeah. We're all 7, right?
I mean, my humanity's pretty high.
Yeah, we're still pretty human.
Are you human?
I'm only at 6 now.
Or are you dancer?
We do have a monster among us.
Yep. And what if God was one of you?
Just a slob, one of us.
Indeed. Yeah, the
just masturbating next to us on a bus.
There goes my brain again.
Don't let me throw this off the rails again.
Bitch.
As Zaire was being implicated for murder.
Right, yes, that's exactly right. Yes, Zaire being implicated for murder. Yeah, the guy looks up and goes, "Actually, it looks a lot like that motherfucker."
He says whoever did it looked a lot like Zaire.
Hmm? Zaire will kind of perk up at that.
Is that just a racist thing, or...?
Do you see where I operate out of? Hell no. Some of our finest boys on the force are black, but they don't look like him. He looks all misty and shit.
What do you mean, misty?
You know, all of you guys look kind of misty and stuff. Some people been walking by and they don't look misty.
Apparently we look misty, guys.
Hmm.
Yeah, it looks a lot like that fucker right there.
I will whisper to Tim that probably means whoever they're looking for is a vampire.
We expected as much.
Did you?
Because it happened
why...
in the day.
The only one who should be suspecting anything would be Claire, and she hasn't said anything about it. Although she has said stuff about a homunculi, but Tim thinks she's talking about fairy tales.
Right. Sorry, I forgot that hadn't actually been relayed. During the daytime? Unlikely.
Shit.
He pauses and goes, "Yeah, it was daytime. Sun just come up a bit ago when it happened. I remember looking at the sun and thinking, damn, that's a lovely sunrise. Shame we gotta go do whatever the hell this is," and then door opened up and bam.
Man, I only have one day till retirement.
Nah, this guy's too young to have been a day from retirement. Instead, he looks up and says, "It's a terrible day for rain, though." No. Yeah. Anything else I can help you folks with?
Well,
Tim,
you said...
Anything else you want
actually, to? Now that nobody's meshing up, Zaire will kind of step closer and say to Rose, "He said that the attacker reminded him of me. Was he around long enough to see any patterns, any fighting style, or military techniques?"
I will ask. Like, how did this guy fight? Did he fight?
I can only assume he did. As I said, I was first one to go, and I don't remember how he killed me. Could have been anything. Yeah, this guy's ghost looks fresh, and it looks like the image he's chosen is not the image of whatever it is that killed him.
Yeah, I think we got everything out of him that we can expect to. We know he was attacked, and we know the person who attacked him looked like the Zaire.
Yeah, the ghost is looking very warily at Zaire.
Height, weight, anything like that you can remember?
He points at Zaire, like he looked like him. I don't know what else to tell you, man.
So everything.
Yeah.
Hairstyle?
He was wearing a trench coat and had a hat. I'm not sure about hairstyle, but looked like him.
This may sound odd, but did you notice shades. Anything about his teeth?
No, I don't remember his teeth. I don't think Fucker was smiling at me when I went down. I don't remember it very well. I'm sorry.
You know where he came from, or
from
what direction he was heading?
I don't know about heading. He was heading out the building. He came from in there, and he points over his shoulder into the building.
Was this like a breaking and entering thing, or?
Oh, call out was, there had been rumors of, you know, like a little bit of drug dealing going on in this area. Maybe someone was trying to make some of their own product. We heard there was gunshots at one point, fighting at one point, and then there was a lot of quiet, and that's when we sent some of our boys in afterwards, maybe for a little bit of a cleanup. We weren't gonna, we're even more understaffed now, aren't we? We weren't gonna go send in boys to just dart ahead of some gangbangers.
Anyone else?
No, I believe we have exhausted all points of inquiry.
Is there any message you'd like me to pass on to loved ones?
Ah, shit, I would rather not think about that. I mean, I got family and stuff, but, how long I been dead?
Well, it's just about... It's coming up on dawn now, so...
Well, I can see we're approaching dawn, but I don't know what... How long I been sat here. Any of you folks know? He doesn't...
When did this happen?
About 3 days ago.
3 days ago.
3 days. I imagine that my family already been told that I've been killed or something. No, I mean, I ain't gonna make my life harder on that, and you're a good lass. I ain't gonna make you pass on some miserable message to my unhappy family. I would ask one thing, though. You know how to send me on the great whatever the hell?
Just gotta...
One just
except that there's nothing here for you.
Well, shit. Guess I have to work on that one. Tell you what, you find that son of a bitch who did this to me. Fitting that son of a bitch over there. And I suppose I'll get all the happiness I need. You sure ain't got a fucking twin? Maybe with a taste in hats.
You got a twin, Zaire?
Not that I know of. Zaire will kind of put his hand on his chin and start thinking of what Zaire would look like.
In a trench coat and fedora? Probably
do
shady.
Do you think if I had an evil twin, he would be bald?
And with a goatee!
Bro should
the
actually...
most evil of facial hair.
I don't know how I forget about the goatee. I'm so glad you're here to remind me of these things.
Well, ain't this jolly. Well, don't let me stop you going in. I mean, it's a crime scene and I should try and stop you, but I suspect I'm incapable.
I mean, pretty much. I think we should head inside, start doing our own investigation.
Well, yeah, there's no need to stop us. We're investigating anyway.
As I said, when I'm not... I would ask you for things like, have you got permission to be... No, never mind. It's beyond my cares these days. You have yourselves a good one. And then he'll shuffle on his perch on the stairs so that you can walk up past him. Admittedly, you would be able to walk through him. And if you all go in the building at, like, roughly the same time, some of you are probably going to walk through him, but he doesn't seem particularly perturbed by that concept.
Some people just get used to the fact they're ghosts.
Yeah, the soul patch is the most evil of facial hair. The goatee still has a bit of class.
Unless you're Teal'c.
Yeah. Also, if you get the Guy Fieri, then you're the worst scumbag. You want to avoid that look. That said, that poster that's just all of his things about talking about burgers is the most hilarious.
Anyways, so heading indoors, yeah, sounds good.
Yeah.
How big is this building? Is this like an entire apartment block, or what are we talking about?
It's probably four apartments, two on the bottom, two on the top. It ain't very tall. It ain't very rich, and the lights inside are off. You've got 2 to 3 hours until sunup, which leaves you enough time to spend upwards of an hour and a half scratching 2 hours to get home afterwards.
Alright. I think the most logical course would be to look for which one has the police tape on it.
Yes, that would be the way to go. I mean, the front of the whole building has police tape, but there is probably going to be more signs inside. However, at this point, I think it is an excellent time for a cliffhanger.
Oh no!
Dun, 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 dun.
Well, that's not very cliffhangery.
Well, I guess. At the very least, we'll leave it off on mystery. Is that acceptable?
Cliffhangery would be like if...
If you are hanging off a cliff. I'm aware of the concept, my dear.
I'm like a Promethean.
Did that actually come
Promethean,
up?
Like, rounded the corner. It's like, arrrr!
Did that term actually come about because characters would be left on literal cliffs?
Yes.
Have you not, like, the movie Cliffhanger?
No.
Anyway.
I probably need to.
So, everyone, you gain a beat for the end of the session. Lily, you gain an extra beat for getting rid of the damned artifact.
Good, good.
The green.
I will be putting one dot into expression. So hopefully I won't be completely fucking useless at dominate now.
Woo! Mm.
And I'll be a little bit better at expressing myself.
Yeah.
General.
You gotta express yourself.
Express yourself!
Alright, DCL, you have not advanced any of your stuff yet.
Say what?
You have not advanced any of your extra stuff yet. So you just have your session beat.
Yes.
Mazendi, you needed to find a priest for St. Mary's Church that has yet to come about. You've got a plus waiting and find out more of the Kai Beats history that won't trigger yet. And seeing Benedict settled into the society socially has a plus beat but has not been progressed. Stray, you never did pick a sixth aspiration. Did you have one in the end?
Yeah. I'm gonna discover the identity of the entity we're hunting.
Okay. That'll probably end up getting a plus beat next session. Right now, nothing happens with it. So.
Clearly, it was Zaire's twin, Congo.
Clearly, it was Zaire possessed by Strix.
I mean, Strix don't exist.
Owls don't exist. Oh, no. There you go. So there he is. Lily wins the experience race this session with a whopping 2 beats.
Woo, good job, you did it.
And is now capable of expressing herself. And with that, is there anything that you guys...
Now I get, like, 4 dice on dominate instead of 2.
Instead of 2. This is good.
Yeah.
You spent a dot and gained 2 dice in a very useful skill. That's a pretty great level up, all things considered.
Mm-hmm.
So, is there anything you would like to ask or do before the session closes?
No. I think I did everything I needed to do.
Anybody else?
No.
Nope.
I'm good.
I didn't get to use Madame Hoots' voice this session. Oh no!
Not this session.
Not this session.
Hoots.
Madame Hoots!
Hoots!
Hoots there!
The purest of characters.
So
who's
pure.
Absolutely pure and not evil at all.
Not even a little bit evil.
Not harboring some horrible grudge against all vampires that have ever existed.
Yeah.
Wanting to dismantle them from the inside and watch them tear themselves apart.
Nope.
That'd be silly.
Yeah, I mean, if out of characterly, DCO, you want to understand the actual situation you've got yourself in right now.
Nope.
Excellent.
Madame Hoots is pure.
Excellent.
Madame Hoots is my pet owl, and she's adorable.
Hoots.
I will spoil her.
Madame Hoots. She's got Hoots and Scoots and Boots.
Skeetsy Beatsy Heatsy.
Alright, with that, see you later, stream. I hope you enjoyed watching. Have yourselves a lovely motherfucking good time.
Bye, stream!